episode 3. Let's get back into it. So, last episode, we finished our last big raid. And y'all remember the big battle that we had to take out our now commander, former peasant revolter. But we got with him. We showed him what the deal was. You know what I'm saying? So now he works for me. He hates my guts. He's probably the biggest hater out there. Hate. You know, he's probably Silky Johnson with his, but hopefully after a year or two of raiding together and, you know, spending some time together, we'll be friends. You never know. Hoping that it all works out. So, episode 3, we got 4 territories. All we want to do right now, first thing that we need to do is do a little bit of upgrades to our army. Again, we're trying to get to about 2,500. If I can get that, I feel like I'll be good. I can basically start any war I want with about 2,500 soldiers in this part of Africa. As I start to move south, I'm gonna have a lot of issues with the Kingdom of Ghana, which usually has anywhere between 5,000 and 7,000 troops, or even further north, going into Spain, where the Umayyad Sultanate usually has anywhere between 4,000 to 6,000 to start off. As time goes on, and they start getting into fights, they start getting into battles, I gotta be careful and mindful. I might be able to steal some money, but in the meantime, let's go on a hunt. This is our first hunt. We're celebrating the new territory, so we'll probably go hunting in Ifni and see what game we can catch there. Hopefully, we can get some prestige. Another 150 would be nice, and we will invest that prestige back into the army. So, thank you, Ertilian, for doing a good job with the soldiers so far. We only got 5 commanders. Let me see if I still remember their names. Mordio, Ertilian, Adam. Okay, wait, let's see. The woods truly is a mantle of the poor, but as the stag flees in panic, I feel my patience weareth thin. Surely there must be better things to do in Grand Canary than picking roots and mushrooms. Guards, drive the rival out of my hunting grounds. I would gain 150, but then the peasants would be mad. And I would lose, negative 30 popular opinion. That's not good. Or a generous donation should keep them away long enough. So I would have to give up 15, but I'll get 100 piety. And then I'll get aided peasants. And that'll give me, poorest people in this country have received significant charitable aid. Development growth plus 10, popular opinion plus 30. Let's do that. It's way smarter. Cool. All right, so we get a little bit of piety, and then once the hunt is over, they should give us another 150 for that. Not bad. So 150 for the prestige, and then an extra 100 for the piety, which I wasn't expecting. So good. All right, so all we've done up to this point, besides capture the 4th territory, we've created the Duchy of Canarias, so congratulations on that. So now you're a chieftain, Cristobal. Mr. Chieftain, with the 4 territories. We still got a lot of work to do. Obviously, first thing, we need to try to find a wife. We need to get married here pretty soon. I like to get married late 20s, early 30s. I probably should wait a little bit longer. Okay, so no, we still haven't got it. So we got 183, we need more money. Okay, so once we get enough money, that's goal number one, is to create the Duchy of Canarias. And as soon as we get enough money, so we're probably gonna have to do another raid in order to get raise the funds, which are gonna be necessary to make it to Duchy. So I don't know which, so what I'll probably do, I think what would be a good idea is if, let's go ahead and upgrade as much as we can. So let's see, we can get some light horsemen. Light horsemen 22, 15, 30, and 30 retreat. So they good in dry lands and in plains. But they bad in the hills, mountains, desert mountains, and in the wetlands. We got a lot of desert mountains in the territories that we're gonna be taking, so it might be better if I go with these camel riders. Now the camel riders 22, 15, 20, and 20, but they have bonuses in the desert, also in the dry lands, in oasis, and in floodplains. Okay, all right. And also, wait, is that a negative? Okay, so, and then the rest of those are negative. So they also have problems in desert mountains, but whatever. At least they're better in the desert, which is a lot of the territory that we're gonna be fighting in. So archers, we got archers, we got our abudars, which are armored footmen, better than just regular soldiers, very dangerous men. And then we got a small cavalry unit as well. So Sheikh Cristobal of Canarias, 21 years old, 4-star general, novice hunter, and holy warrior. So thank you. They gave me that one. I don't know where that one came from, but we'll take it. Thank you so much. So now it's time for us to find an appropriate mate. So let's do this by age. We want somebody young that's gonna be around. See, like, there's two ways to approach this. You can get somebody young, like 13 or 14, which would give you an extra 2 years of grinding and raiding and doing those type of things before she comes to court. You can go really, really young, like 5, and then you got like an additional 10 years. But if something happens, for example, if you die or if you get your dick cut off in war or battle, or like if you get sick and you get cancer, or then basically your shot at having kids goes out of the window. So you have to try to find a balance. You don't want to do it when you're too young, right? You want to give yourself about a 15 to 20 year gap between you and your kids. So then that way when they're in their 20s, you're like in your 40s and in your 50s, and by then you should have done basically everything that you needed to do. And then you can start passing over some of the responsibilities to your heir in the hopes that, you know, you trained him up well. He's ready to take the mantle if and when you die. This lady looks interesting. Stephanie de Kirchie. Stephanie. So she's honest, she's calm, and temperate. Okay. So let's see, can I seduce? Ooh, 0%, damn. Well, damn, girl. No success chance. She doesn't like wrathful. And her opinion of me is negative 35. I'm a good dude. What's wrong with me? From the goddamn Perchie family. All right, Stephanie Perchie, well, guess what? Your daddy is who controls this shit. And if your daddy say, you gotta get married to me, bitch, guess what? We get motherfucking married. I don't give a fuck. You gonna be all right. You gonna learn to love me is what you gonna be. See that? Your daddy with it. He knows that I'm a good dude. So let's get married. Well, let me send a proposal. Yeah, you will be a good mother to my children because you honest, you calm, and you're temperate. Those are very good qualities that I like in a woman. So she has 2 brothers. Her mom and her daddy's still alive. She's an honorable planner and she's French. So one of the things that I like about the new DLC is that they do give you the ability to learn another language, but fuck that. She living in my court. Bitch, you better learn how to speak fucking Baranis or what do we speak? Like fucking Arabic. But you better learn how to speak that fucking Arabic, because otherwise, I don't know what to fucking tell you. I'm not learning French. She's scared of me, though. She a little bit scared. With her negative, she a little bit nervous. She's Like, yeah. But like, I was just trying to touch your head. Relax. Ain't nobody trying to hit you. Damn. I'm not crazy. What's wrong with you? Stop jumping every time you see me. So she's still... she like positively scared of me now. Fuck, man. This short is crazy. Chieftain Stephanie. All I know is that even though I can't seduce you or... Well, maybe I could romance. Let's see. So they wouldn't let me do a seduction, but can I do a romance game? Let's try to rope. Damn! 0% for the romance too? Damn. And she not gay? Totally lesbian though. I'm joking. Not lesbian, but she just don't like me. Wow. Well, whatever. Whatever. We gonna get to know each other. Cause you here now, goddammit. You live here. So anyway, I tell you what, you get comfortable in the castle. I gotta get the fuck out of here. I'm not comfortable in my own house no more. Just trying to talk to her, she be running out of the room, slamming doors, crying and shit. Like, the fuck is you crying for? You got a beautiful home now. I mean, it's a hut, right? But how you go from living in the castle to living on the floor of a hut? She just like, fucked up. She like, this is some bullshit. I get it. It might be some bullshit for you because you probably used to living in that high life. And here, we don't live like that yet. We not at that point. But I tell you what, I want you to be happy. And I know that you used to having nice things. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go out on this raid. I'm going to be gone for about a year. That should give you enough time to learn my language. That should give you enough time to meet my couriers or the people in my court. I'm taking all the commanders so you can meet the wives, all the ladies that's back, Gita and them. Gita will show you around. Crazy. Jealous Gita. A little bit of advice about Gita, okay? Don't look at her in her eyes. And don't talk to Ertillian. Well, Ertillian is out with me anyway, so she ain't gonna get a chance to. But Gita's fucking crazy. Gita's our crazy, jealous spy master. She'll cut a bitch throat. She will cut a bitch. Anybody that look at Ertillian. But we be having a lot of situations in the court where she be trying to cut all the bitches because they be like trying to talk to Ertillian, but just to be like, hello, sir. She's like, bitch, I'll kill you. She's like, whoa, calm the fuck down. You the only one want that crazy ass dude. Y'all made for each other. Relax. So we already got a little bit of drama in the court because her Chilean wife is a fucking nutbag. So we got a little over 1,400 troops. We got our 5 captains. Now what we want to do is we're not trying to fuck with the Emirate of Marrakesh just yet. That motherfucker looks a little bit strong. And it would take all of my troops to fight him. I would lose a lot of troops. So we're just going to bypass him. We're going to get up in here near Morocco, up near the Gulf, the passing into Spain. But we're not going to go into Spain just yet. No. The plan is to... hold on, let me see. Yeah, so the plan is to go into Ceuta. Sueta, could be Sueta, like sweater, or Ceuta. The plan is to go into Ceuta first, and then after that, we'll just make our way down, you can't see my finger, down the coast, but up into the east. So let's see, we got our guy Hesso, who is our court physician, who's lazy, forgiving. We got Abdul Azim, and we got him married. We got Munio, and we got him married. I think his wife's name is Lisa. Munio is a 3-star general, but he's robust. And Munio also had a daughter. Congratulations, Munio. You got a baby girl. Aw. So cute. What is... that's Miasa. Okay, so yeah. He already had a daughter. Okay, and I'm the one that's training her. If I'm not mistaken. Yeah, she's under me. She's doing pretty well. She's a 4 at the age of 5. Usually we like to see about a 5 at 5, but whatever. She's a girl. They go Artillion and his crazy wife. Artillion is a 4-star general. Artillion, congratulations on the birth of your daughter. God damn. Is everybody, all the girls in the corps gonna be named Gita? Gita probably hates the other Gita and probably wanna fight her every chance she get. So we'll send Gita to the priest, Silanoth, because he's diligent, even though he's greedy, but he's zealous. Oh no, he's infirm. So he's not feeling well. So he'll be teaching her from bed. But since she's just a little baby, she can help him. And he'll have help too, because they're in the temple hut. Adam is also married now. He's a 1-star general, holy warrior, and a logistician. But Yugi is not one of our captains. He's a 3-star spy master, but I'm currently using Yugi as my money guy. So basically, while we make our way north, up towards some of these upper territories to get our raid on, what we're basically doing now is just going through the court, making sure that everything is set up properly. We still got 2 months in Canarias to change the culture there. I can't even remember what culture I chose. Was it Iberian, maybe? I don't remember. Or maybe it was Baranius. I don't remember. But we need to change the culture. Whatever my culture is, this is going to be the culture in Canarias. We've already finished with the change to religion. So that's good. And right now, the chancellor doesn't really have any jobs. There's nothing really for him to do. All right, so we're getting close. We're coming through Morocco. Again, we just had to get out of the house. We wanted to give our wife some time to get comfortable. All that bitch do is cry. Just crying and crying and crying. I have no idea what the fuck is wrong with her. Maybe she's not comfortable sleeping on the mats in our hut. But I mean, what the fuck? So my goal is to go out here, make some money. Hopefully, with the money that I make, or the proceeds that we make from this raid, we'll be able to upgrade some things in that castle. So like, I don't know if we've already started work on the longhouse, but that bitch see that it's construction happening in the capital. She see all of the slaves that we've captured so far, and that, you know, I mean, people living pretty good lives. It's not just the hut, it's the main hut. We got like a main, we got a big ass fire in there. We got food every day. How many people you know got food every day? Like, she'd be wanting, she'd be like mad because we don't be having like roasted duck. Bitch, ain't no roasted duck on this fucking island, is you stupid? We got fish and platanos. That's it. Fish and platanos. Or platanos and fish. You can mix it up if you want to, but that's it. Ain't no motherfucking cheese and French bread and all that shit here. What the fuck you think this is? You want some wine? We ain't got wine. We got mead. You like mead? You ever tasted mead before? You don't like it? You spit it out? I don't know what the fuck to tell you. After a couple of days of that shit, I was like, you know what? I gotta go raid. So we gonna get our raid on, and I'll be back in about 8 months. Maybe when I get back, she'll be used to eating the fish and platanos, and she'll feel better about her situation, because I don't know what the fuck to tell her. We practice a tribal system, a tribal way of life. That's the way it is. And it's going to be like that for a while. I'm sorry. I don't know what to tell you. That's just how it is in Grand Canarias. I think that it's important to start off as tribal, and then you get the opportunity, number one, to raid, which is very important. Number two, the soldiers that you get do not come out of your bank account. It comes out of your prestige, which is much easier to obtain at this stage in the game. You need to raid to get cash. Use the cash to upgrade your soldiers in your army. Once your army is upgraded, by that time, and you're ready to transition over to a feudal system, you already have a big ass, mean ass standing army. And yeah, that standing army is going to cost you money, but if you manage your territories properly, you should have enough money to cover the expenses that come with having a decent sized army. And by decent sized army, I mean about 3,000 to 4,500 with an additional 1,500 to 3,000 from your holy order if you're able to create one. So these are goals that we have. We want to create the Duchy of Canarias. That's going to be the first thing. So that means that I'll go from just a normal chieftain to high chieftain, which should at least make my wife a little bit happy, considering I have a bigger title, we'll be making a little bit more money, and I have a little bit more prestige. That should make her happy. Besides that, I'll connect or unite the three islands with our two territories from the mainland, or the two territories that we have from the mainland, which is Ifni and Agadir. Now, once we have the duchy created, at that point, what we want to do is get all of the de jure counties that are a part of our duchies. Once we have that, we can then give out some of those territories to our most trusted commanders. So then that way they have the opportunity to, build a life, build a castle for their families. And that's how we keep the cycle going. We create everything from Grand Canarias. All roads lead back to Grand Canarias. All loyalty comes back to Grand Canarias. But in order to get there, we gotta get our grind on. Fickleness of use. So Miyasa, okay, so we knew that. She's already changed to studying warfare. All right, so with the power of editing, what we're going to do is we're going to fast forward to the actual raid. So let's fast forward to the raid. Oh man, so our guy died, so we got a new bishop. Oh man. All right, so let's see what's going on with wifey. Let's check in with her. Chieftess Stephanie. So I want you to educate that baby, because now the court, because we lost the reverend, tell my wife I want her to be the one to train those two babies until we get someone else. So that should give her something to do. All right, so now she already has two. Well, she has two? Who's the other person that she's monitoring? Who is that little boy? Amar. Oh, so that's her little brother. What the fuck? Lover? Wifey cheating? She got a motherfucking lover? Duke Rammel's spy master, a evil lackey. Who the fuck is this bitch nigga? Oh, Eddie already married. Oh, Kimfo. Oh man, hold up, bro. We gonna have to talk, man. We gonna have to talk, bro. I'm sorry, man, but you out of there, my dude. You fucking out of there. 9%? Damn. You are fucking out of there, my dude. I'ma fucking murder you. You can't be fucking my wife, man. What's wrong with you? No wonder that bitch was crying. That's what she was crying for. She missed this nigga. Catholic, French, but he a good soldier. He a holy warrior too. But we the same religion, so what? Military engineer. Ain't that a bitch? Oh man. So only 21% chance. Let's see if we can't get somebody to help us out with this shit. I'll pay whatever it is that they need me to pay. How much? God damn, $55. Shit. All right, man, I'll pay. That motherfucker gotta go. He gotta go. Can't believe this shit, man. Damn, I ain't even been gone that long. She must have been fucking that nigga before she even came to my court. Oh, man. That's why it's important to check your wives, man. I should have... Oh, no! My wife, cheats and Stephanie, is with child, and I should be overjoyed. However, she's been acting strange, and I cannot shake the feeling that something is wrong. Am I really the father, as she claims, or has she betrayed our union? First of all, I ain't touched the bitch. I ain't even fucking yet. Maybe once when we first got married that first night. No. I gotta look into this. I don't trust that bitch. Oh man. Horrible. Drama in the chieftain. How's she gonna play me like that? Because I'm just a lowly chief? Because I'm out here trying to build something from nothing? She like rich dudes? Is that what it is? She like him because he live in a castle or a house or some shit? She don't like the huts? What, he be eating fish with extra chips? Or fish with extra platanos? I don't know what the fuck they eat in France. Whatever fancy food they eat, maybe it's not raw fish. Maybe they know how to cook the fish and it's not like on an open fire. I don't know. I've never been to France. But what I do know is that she gonna pay for this. That bitch is gonna pay for this. Stay tuned for the drama unfolding in Grand Canaries. Catch y'all next week.